We have seen recursive version of factorial program. So here we will explain how this program is working. So in case the value of a is 5, main would call reg within 5. So if we are taking 5's factorial, then value of a will be 5. Main would call reg with 5 as its actual argument, and reg will send back the computed value. But before sending the computed value, reg calls reg and waits for value to be returned. So first we will enter 5. So first 5 is computed. Now before sending the computed value, reg calls reg and waits for a value to be returned. It is possible for REC that has just been called to call yet another reg. Now reg 5 returns 5 times reg 4. So when we enter A as 5, so reg 5 will return 5 times reg 4, which returns 4 times reg 3. Now which returns 3 times reg 2, which returns 2 times reg 1, which returns 1. Foxed, that means are you confused? Well, that is recursion. For you in simplest graphs, I hope you agree that it's difficult to visualize how the control flows from one function call to another function call. So it is difficult to understand recursion. That means we are here multiplying 5, then 4, then 3 by 2. So here it is difficult to visualize how the control flows from one function call to another function call. Possibly, so we will see a figure now, would make things a bit clearer. Assume that the number entered through scanf is 3. So we have entered 3, and which is recognized by scanf. So this is a figure of recursion from which it will be easy for understanding what recursion is. So let us visualize what happens when recursive function rec is called. So here first it is written that from main. So from main, arrow is pointing towards rec rec int x. So x is an integer here. So from main we are going to rec, that is recursion. Now inside recursion, int f, so f is an integer and x is an integer, so int x is written. If x is equal to 1, return to 1. That means return to 1 means return to f. Else, so else f is equal to x into multiplied by rec x minus 1 and return to f and return to main. So this was first step. Now if these steps will be repeated. Now visualize number entered as a 3. Assume that number 3 is entered. Go through figure carefully. The first time when the rec is called, from main x collects 3. So in first time x is collecting 3 from here, since x is not equal to 1. So first if 3 is written or 3 is calculated, so 3 is not equal to 1, so it will be performed as else statement. So 3 into recursion of 3 minus 1, that is 2. So 3 is not equal to 1, then if block is skipped, so if statement is skipped, an else statement is carried out. Now a new argument will be there, that is 3 minus 1, 2. So rec 3 rec 2, This is a recursive call. Now this is recursive call. Since x is still not equal to 1, so rec will be 2. So 2 is not equal to 1. So again it is compared as x is equal to 1. So which is 2? So 2 is not equal to 1. So rec is again called another time. So 2 into, so else statement will be again carried out. F is equal to 2 star rec 2 minus 1. That is 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1. So rec 2, rec 1 will be carried out. Now rec is 1. So rec is 1, that means it will be compared in if block, that is x equal to, so x is 1 now. So if x is equal to 1 means 1 is equal to 1. So x is 1 now. So it will be returned to main. So that is how this recursion function is working.